What did you do with Marnie?
She's on the cutting room floor.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, one and all, to the Cutting Room Floor. I'm Dylan Cloud, joined today fresh off the ice rink by Marino Lupo. How you doing today, man?
I'm doing good, man. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm in an especially good mood, and you know, another collector episode we're doing today. And while we're on that subject, I've had a couple questions about my collection, and just so everyone's clear, my collection's in a closet, so it's really difficult for me to show it off. The set pieces you see behind me are literally the only thing in the room at the time. So from this point going forward, I'm just going to have one piece behind me that I will explain per episode so everyone can see what I have, because I'm not pulling all my shit out of the closet. This, however, is my new 97 Asus, which anyone familiar with Scream will know this is the mask from Scream 3, given to me by Austin Turner. So thanks, brother. Much appreciated. It is, at the time of recording, it is, February 6th today, I think. Just got this yesterday, so for anyone watching, this is probably March or April you're seeing this. We record a lot of stuff in advance. But enough about me. We're here to talk about Marino's collection, and I want to let the people know you are a young man.
That's something that a lot of people don't know. I'm 16.
So, you know, you're a young man, and you've already amassed quite an amazing collection. It's usually the part where I ask how you've gotten into horror, but, you know, you're literally... that you don't know what the 90s are. So how did you get into horror?
So basically, I've been into the holiday of Halloween since I was, 3 or 4 years old. And I was just really always obsessed with like the costumes people wore trick-or-treating. And, I would occasionally see horror movies come on TV and I would start watching them. And I think one of the first horror movies I've actually seen was Halloween 6. And once I saw like the Michael Myers mask, I was like, oh my God, like that's the coolest thing ever. Like I want to get these, but I didn't know how to, I was so young. And, I think what really, really jumped me into it was, going to my first convention when I was 5. My uncle was in a famous band and TV show in the 60s called the Monkees. And so I was with him while he was signing autographs at a table. And when I was with him, one of his security members, like bodyguards, would take me around occasionally just to look around. And he would take me up to people's tables like Kane Hodder and I forget who else was there at that specific one. But I remember specifically Kane Hodder was like the first horror person I ever met. And I just thought he was the coolest thing, the coolest guy ever. And seeing, all the figures and masks and stuff around me, I was like, this is like the best place on earth, because they got all the stuff here that I find so incredibly cool and stuff that I want like surrounding me everywhere. So I just was obsessed with it ever since and just try to get as many pieces as possible since then. Mostly not good pieces, but yeah.
Those who see you active in Facebook groups, often see anyone got any JC pieces for sale, and anyone who knows about, the independent mass market is those things ain't cheap. I don't have any JC pieces.
They're not cheap.
And being as young as you are, how do you manage to have so much amazing stuff without spending copious amounts of money?
Well, the thing is, though, with some things you do spend a copious amount of money. But I really started up my whole fund with one independent mask. It was a CGP Warlock. And I traded it not too long ago for a few other masks, for multiple masks, which then I ended up selling. Which I started buying higher quality stuff, for more money, getting more things, trading them, selling them, gathering up, some money and having it reserved for pieces that I really wanted to get, like my KHU is probably my top mask. And I paid for that. I didn't trade anything for that. I spent the money that I got from selling other masks that I've had.
So just, get a mask here, make a slight upgrade, sell, repeat.
Right, right.
So for anyone watching, you don't have to have $2,000 to get the things you want. Patience and a little business savvy will get you a long way.
That's true. Within the past, I'm going to say month, maybe month and a half, I went through 20 masks already. I only had that Warlock up until maybe December, the beginning of December, end of November is where I really started to really get into this stuff and really start making trades and sales and buying stuff. That's when I really started picking up.
So let's start showing the people the fruits of those labors. What's the first piece you want to show off?
The first piece I want to show off. That's a good question. I'll start off with an H1. I feel most people are fans of the H1s. So I'll show my newest piece I got in here. This is a NAG AHG 75K Castle. And it's definitely the best H1 I've had, just the solid H1. I've had a few H1s, like the PS78 was probably my last really solid H1. Oh, wait, no, and I have the NAG Nightmare too. But this one is really, you know, when I wear it, it looks really good. And I love AHG's work. I had an AHGX maybe a few weeks ago, which I ended up trading for a mask I have now. But yeah, so this first piece here is the AHG NAG 75K Castle, which actually was originally owned by Brandon Zachman. It's got his name on the inside of it.
I remember when he got that mask, and it's one of the ones he held onto for a while. So his, yeah, you know, refined palate, you know, that fucking New York asshole. I always have to give him shit. But no, that's definitely a high quality piece. And
oh, yeah,
given how little AHG produces these days, you know, it's kind of hard to get your hands on, especially right, newer ones.
And I've always wanted a castle. The castle has always been my favorite sculpt that Nikos did for H1. I like the 98 proto and the 98 test, but damn, you know, I like so many sculpts that he does, but this is one of my favorites I've wanted for a while, because I've seen pictures of like JC castles, and that to me is probably to my own personal like H1 like full grail I can get, because this JC castle to me is like, it just, you know, there's some masks that do it for people. That's the one that does it for me for H1. But this is, you know, pretty much the same. Like, this is, you can't really get much better than this. Like, in my opinion, I've seen JC masks in person. Like, I've seen Brandon's in person at Monster Mania. I don't know how long ago it was, but I've seen his 98 Proto JC, and I was like blown away by that. But yeah, for sure, this is my favorite H1 that I have.
That one's amazing. You display yours on paper towels?
Yeah, you know, usually paper towels, and I put a plastic bag over it. It really does the job. Everybody else has their own, ways of doing it. You know, some people spend money and get, you know, the custom mask stands or styrofoam heads, which, you know, most people do. Some people do soda bottles and just put, you know, plastic bags on top of them. I mean, it's just a solid, you know, base at the bottom, so they don't really have to worry about anything tipping over. And if you really just put, you know, some plastic bags over it, it's really fine. Yeah, it does the job.
You know, the foam heads I use, like what this is sitting on, you know, I get them for $3 a pop. I've definitely used paper towels in the past. They work great. They're easy to stuff, and like you said, they got a good firm foundation, and they don't break the bank.
Yeah.
What else we got for the people?
What else? I'll just go through everything. Well, not everything, but I'll go through some stuff. This here is not a favorite mask by many, but I like this mask. It's the Revenge of the Fifth H5 mask. I think it's number 24, and it was originally James Grimm's mask. It's still tagged. I'm probably going to wear this at a convention coming up in March. Personally, I think it's one of the best H5s you can get out there. I know there's the SSN Shanks, but, you know, those go for quite a bit since they're pretty rare. But overall, this really is a great sculpt, and I really love the paint he did on it and the hair. I think it's fake human hair, but it fits great on me personally.
I had one in the past, and for clarity, you know, that mask isn't hated because it's a bad mask. It's hated because of the person who produces it.
Yeah. No, I love this mask.
But no, it's a great mask because it's a recast. So I mean, it's gonna be great. You know, it's recasted off of the screen mask. But you know, he'll never admit that. But no, I love it from the profile. I mean, it just screams that first scene in the movie where he, or in the prison scene where he's just sitting there, like the profile on the Revenge is perfect. But
oh yeah,
no, that's definitely good.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna give that one up anytime soon. My goal for my collection is to have for myself at least one major grail for each movie. And until I have that one perfect mask for each movie, I'm never really. I know it sounds bad, but I just can't be like satisfied. I just like for me, I think currently I have my all-time grails for H2, H5, and now Resurrection, which I'll talk about later. But the next masks, I'll show. I mean, I'll go over this one real quick.
Now, I wasn't just, you know, writing down a bucket list. That has been tremendously helpful for me, is deciding what I want to get instead of just acquiring a lot of stuff that really save you a lot of time and money.
Yeah, that's what I do. But, you know, most of the time to get the pieces that I want, they're usually on the higher end of the price spectrum. So I have to keep working my way up, buying, trading, selling, you know, doing what I basically did for the KHU, which was a real big pain in the ass to get, but it was worth it. I don't know if everybody knows the story, but I originally bought one off of a guy named Eric Long off of MM.net, and it turned out to be a scammer, never even had the mask, was sending me pictures of which now I know was a cage he belonged to another guy, and went through this whole ordeal with PayPal, which took 10 days. It doesn't sound that long of a time, but when you have that amount of money out on the line that you just sent to somebody, it's kind of scary, you know, to think about, like, oh, what if I don't get this money back? Because I think at the time he had like 1,600 of my money, and I couldn't touch it until, you know, the whole case got reviewed and everything like that, until I eventually acquired it back. But it was a scary time for a little bit there, because I wasn't sure if I was going to get it back, because I never went through anything with PayPal like that before, and I wasn't really sure how it worked. But ultimately, PayPal came through, I got my money back, and I bought the KHU I have now.
But that'd be a lesson to all, stay off of shithead.net.
Also, always pay with goods and services, unless you're really close to the person that you're sending money to, you know. But always, if you're buying first time or not really too familiar, always use goods and services through PayPal, because shit like that can happen. And if you have the proof to show that they scammed you, you'll mostly get your money. You'll most of the time get your money back. I don't see why there's a reason why you wouldn't if you have the proof. But yeah.
What's that H4 you're holding right there? It looks like a Tots.
It's the Tots H4. I redid the hair a little bit on it because it was a bit kind of fucked up personally when I got it. I just really slicked it back just a bit and trimmed it. But I mean, it's not a bad H4, honestly. I mean.
No, it matches for me, especially if you have Ryan Truhoff do it, it matches the stunt mask perfectly.
Oh, yeah, no, I agree. I mean, I know it's a Tots mask, but it's got to be, in my opinion, one of the better H4s out there if you're not really looking to spend too much on an H4. I mean, I really want to get an AHG H4 in the future, but
good luck with that.
They're up for sale. I mean, one of my buddies, Ryan, has one for sale. He has an AHG stunt for sale for, I think, like $425 right now, if I'm not mistaken.
Because I know Ryan, whenever there's an AHG out there, he sucks it up.
Oh, yeah. Like, I traded in my AHGX for this Revenge of the Fifth he has here.
So, you know, you're only going to get one if he okays it, because he's got, like, 19 of them.
Oh, yeah, he's got a lot. He's only been collecting for, like, a year. He's got a ton of masks.
Oh, yeah, he's like you, man. He's amassing a collection like that. But, yeah. I, you know, when I look at the Tots H4, it shares a lot of resemblance for me to the to the NAG H4, the NAG Hero. So, I mean, that's a great one as well. So, if you're looking for not spend a ton of money, and, you know, if you want to stay around $250, get a Tots H4 and send it to Ryan Truhoff. And that's not, you know, he's not telling me to say that. I just think his work is amazing. I like putting him over because it's astounding.
Yeah, I agree. I've talked to him a few times about different stuff, and I think his work on H4s and H40s are awesome. I like all of his stuff. He's really, really a top-notch guy. More people should go check him out, for sure. There's a lot of artists out there that really don't get the recognition they deserve because, you know, everybody, you know, goes to, you know, the same two, three people, you know, JC, Loper. There's nothing wrong with them. They're both, you know, they're amazing. But when people say rehauls, they just think of those two guys automatically. I've had a Loper mask. I've never had a JC. I want one really bad. Just gotta wait for one to pop up the right time. Because I mean, I would get one directly from him, but his wait time is about 5 years, and you know, 5 years from now, I'm, you know, who knows what's going on with that, you know?
Absolutely.
Yes,
that's why you know, it's one reason I started doing the show is to give more guys like Bill Blake and Matt Reed and Rodney Parm and all these guys some more love, because you know, JC and Loper, for the most part, they do ones and twos and not a whole lot of twos. So you know, and there's plenty of other people who do them, but you know, a lot of those, you got your threes, your fours, five, six, seven, eight, Rob Zombies. Though there's a lot of other channels you can go through to get something you like.
Yeah, no, for sure. Bill Blake's also another great guy. I think everybody should go check out at I think Devil's Reign FX. I know there was a slight issue not too long ago with me and the group. There was a misunderstanding, but I had Bill's HTK and I really liked it. The only problem was that I got a really big head and it didn't fit me. And it doesn't usually matter what the mask is. If I have a mask in my collection, I want to have it to wear if I choose to, but also, you know, to have it on display. I really don't want one for one or one for the other. I just want a mix of something that looks, you know, good on display, which it did, but it just didn't fit me. It was a real struggle to get my head in it. So I ended up selling it to a guy not too long ago. But I'll show you my H6 in the KH. Does that sound good?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, all right, let me get the H6 is on a life size right now, right behind me. But, yeah, this is a pretty interesting H6 mask. Of course. Oh, I'll wait a few seconds there. Anyway. So, yeah, this H6 mask is really interesting. This is called the Bloodline H6 mask, and it's by an artist named Cletus Cassidy, also known as James Ferreria, I'm pretty sure. As far as my knowledge goes, this thing was only sold in Europe, and there's only two, I think, currently in the U.S. But yeah, I mean, overall, sculpt-wise, it's not a bad mask. I mean, I know there's a lot of issues with James and everything like that. Chris was telling me some stuff about him, and I've heard some horror stories about him too, you know. But I mean, putting the actual maker aside, the mask itself is pretty good. I mean, aside from, you know, Chris's H6s or Brad Harden's H6s, this is right up there personally with them, because it's pretty good. I mean, I got really nothing bad to say about it. The hair on it's good. I mean, the sculpt overall, the paint. The only issue I have with this mask is when I wear it, the neck comes up really high. Because again, I have a big head and I guess a longer neck, but when I wear it, it pops out and I can't get it to go underneath the coveralls. That's why I was trying to trade it or sell it. And I was going to get either a Harden or mask from Chris, but I just wish it would fit me a bit better. I mean, I'll probably end up wearing it to convention, because I don't really see anybody buying this or trading for it anytime soon. But I mean, overall, I think it's a great H6.
And what I'll tell people is, if you want one with a longer neck, I'd go with the Harden. But if you know, if there's a mask out there that you're wanting to buy and it's from someone who's a little less than reputable, we'll say, I always just tell people, just don't buy it firsthand. Don't give that person more money. But if it's already out there, then there's no reason for you to pass it up. You know, I'm sure you didn't buy that firsthand from James. So it's not you're not supporting a recaster anymore. You know, so if you enjoy it, that's all that matters. You know, if you always can upgrade to something you like even more, that's great. You know, I've got a reigning red, and I plan to get a curse from Chris, or if you get one from Harden himself, you know, I mean, you can't go wrong. But I like that for sure. It's a bit different. You know, the hair's got a nice red tint to it, and I'm digging it.
Yeah, I mean, you may know more about James than I do, but was this a recast or was this original by him?
Honestly, I don't know a whole lot about the James situation. If I'm correct, I believe it's a recast. But
it's
whatever.
It's got a signature in the back of the mask, like in the actual, like latex. Like it's like engraved. There's an S back there, which was his usual thing he does.
I would say Chris is, you know, if Chris was telling you some stuff, he's generally pretty on the money when it comes to histories of things. And yeah. If he told you it's a recast, it's probably a recast.
He didn't say specifically this mask, but he was talking about other masks.
I do believe James has a pretty shady past, if I'm not mistaken.
He definitely does.
Yeah.
He definitely does. And I personally probably wouldn't be 100% confident getting something from directly, but he doesn't even sell to the U.S. anymore, as far as I'm concerned. So, is what it is. I also heard, like, whenever he comes out with a new mask, he it comes out under a new name. Like, he makes up a fake name for, like, every mask he does now, which is kind of...
And that might be just to disguise the past and get people to forget about it in the past. You know, make a slight retool to something that was kind of, you know, outed as something dishonest in the past to make people think of it under a new name. But once you tarnish your reputation, I mean, it's kind of tarnished.
Yeah, I mean, no matter what, people are really going to find out who you are. And, you know, it's not really going to go good for you. But, yeah, I guess I'll show the KH and then... I guess that's all I got for now to show, but this is definitely my top piece. I really don't think I can get any better than this personally, unless I got something that was screen used. But this KH is like, I can't say enough good things about it. Like, it's from every angle, it just looks like H2 to me.
What I'll tell people about the KHU is, one, Ken's a dick, but it's a great mask because he personally worked with the hero. So, you know, like you'll see a lot of masks that are current replicas, but this was made to be an H2. So it is right. One reason it kind of stands above the other ones, and hence the price tag that it has. Yeah. I love the KHU. I think other than maybe, you know, a proto or a test mold from James Carter, you can't get any better, especially since you get a piece of hero hair with the KHU.
You're not going to be able amazing. To see it, but it's on the back of this COA. And then it's also, a lot of people don't know, there's a white patch. It's hard to see. There's a white patch in there. I don't know if you can see it.
Yeah.
Right there. And it's got the hair in the latex in there. I have yet to get a black light to shine it on the face, you know, to see the skull and everything. But I've never had a mask like this. The latex feels like something I've never felt before, and so is the hair. It's like the softest latex I've ever felt in my life. Like, softer than like Nikos's latex, which is pretty, you know, hard to say. But like, the hair too is, I don't know what it is, the hair, but it's like, it's styled perfectly, and the color and everything. On camera, it's not really going to show the weathering as it is, you know, in person, but this thing's awesome. I'll actually throw it on real quick. Show you live,
you know. And definitely. Ken did spend a tremendous amount of time with Dick Warlock in the mask and also matching the hair to it. That's why he got that bit of hero hair from Dick, was to match it. That's, you know, that the details there, there's no denying that it's amazing. Oh, Ken's yeah. a douche and he's full of himself, but he did make a great, you know, mask. And I don't think you can get any better than that. It's just so good.
I think from, like, almost any angle, this thing, like, just screams a hero. Like, it's pretty hard, like, to beat this mask, in my opinion. That's why I had to get it, you know. For me, it fits perfectly, too, like, the neck length, the face. Everything fits perfectly with me in it. But, yeah, like, I don't know, man. Like, this mask, I'm trying to look in the camera, but it looks pretty good from what I see. But...
Oh, no, I dig it. It's great.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. I'm not gonna wear it for too long. This is one mask I don't necessarily like wearing for a long amount of time. Just given, like, you know, the price on it, I really don't want to risk anything. This is probably the only mask you'll see me, like, kind of be like babying almost to an extent, because it was a lot of
price tag. You need to.
Yeah, it was a lot of money, and I will try to preserve and protect this thing at all costs. But actually, the care sheet that Ken sent with it was pretty interesting. He really went into detail about how to take care of this thing and preserve it for a long time, and you know, how he recommends taking care of it, and what, you know, just some recommendations that he made, and some details he added about the mask and details on it and history and whatnot. But yeah, this is the KHU, which a lot of people ask me questions about on Instagram. Because a lot of people want this mask. And to be honest, there's not really a lot of videos out there on YouTube displaying them or talking about them. I mean, Loris Melkor made a pretty good one. Great shots in it. Loris is a good friend of mine. He's got a lot of amazing pieces as well. But besides that, I think there was like a few other videos just, you know, showing the mask but not really talking about it. But I mean, this thing is, I can't say enough good things about it. I got nothing really to say bad about this mask. It's just, I don't see, there's no flaws on it really. Just the paintwork's really phenomenal. I'm really surprised at it, and very, very, very happy with it. I definitely say it's worth the money I spent on it, and that's I guess really all that matters at the end of the day is if you're happy with what you spent on it and happy with what you got. It doesn't matter what other people's opinions are or what they think. If it's your mask, and you should be getting what makes you happy, and if you're happy with it, that's really all that matters. I think a lot of people get too caught up with people that are, you know, just starting to collect, or they want, you know, whatever the best mask is. They get too caught up in other people's personal opinions on what they like and what they think is the best. And they just sometimes listen to other people. Like, you know, some people argue that this is the best and that's the best. You know, personally, I think that's the best H2. I mean, other people have their own opinions. Everybody should have their own opinions on what they think is the best and just get what makes you happy, you know. Don't get this because this one said that, and, you know, if I get this, a lot of people are going to like it. Or get what you personally like. Don't listen to other people's, you know, input about, you know, what you're going to spend your money on.
Unless you seek the input first.
Right.
Because, you know, like, you know, and some people just have a, you know, like a cap, you know, like my Austin, who helped me get this mask, he has a Gen 1 Fantastic. He has a Gen 1 Fantastic White Shroud that he, between the two of them, spent, what, north of $1,000. I would personally never do that, but that's just me. Does it mean he made a bad purchase? Just one that I wouldn't make. But you know what? He's got amazing Scream 1 mask that I'll never have because I'm just not willing to pay it. My preference for the Scream 3 mask. I think it's the symmetrical face that does it for me. It's amazing. You know, I would never pay for a KHU. Just my preference. But again, it's probably the best H2 you can get. I'm never going to have it for that reason. But that doesn't mean that you're wrong or that you're dumb for doing it or that I'm wrong or dumb for not doing it. Everyone enjoys the hobby how they want to do it, which has always been my point, and that's why I guess preach so much about it. You know, for people just shut the fuck up, just keep scrolling and leave other people alone. Like it or keep going. You're happy, that's all that matters. And you're enjoying the hobby, that's what we're here for.
You don't like I feel like there's other groups out there, not naming names, but it's more of an elitist type, you know, thing. And people are like, oh, you know, everybody's in it for the same reason, for the same love of having and collecting masks, you know. But, you know, say like, you know, someone posts their JC mask, right? And then somebody posts a less expensive, maybe lesser quality mask. You know, everybody starts going attacking this guy like, oh, it's a piece of shit. You know, it's trash. Get out of here. But I think people forget that, you know, everybody's, you know, first pieces weren't JCs. At least I don't think they were. I mean, you know, everybody has their budgets and what they can afford. And if they're happy with whatever they can afford, that's the whole point of, you know, collecting, is to have what you have and be happy with it. No, not, you know, going the whole getting, you know, fucking whatever pieces you have just to impress other people or to fit in. You know, it's not about that. I honestly, other people's opinions, really, I could care less about it, the negative, whatever. As long as I'm happy, which I am, with what I have, that's all I care about. I just share my pictures online because, you know, it makes me happy, you know, to show what I have. And, you know, some of my friends comment, you know, like, oh, you know, nice, whatever. And I do the same for my other friends. You know, I like the stuff they have. They like the stuff I have. It's, you know, mutual thing. And that's why I started my own group. Because I'm really tired of BS in other groups, as you can imagine. Not Michael Myers mask collector. That's fine. But there's, you know, tons of other mask collecting groups that there's just too much bullshit that goes on. And too much drama, I think, in a hobby where it's all over, you know, it's all about latex masks. Like, there's grown men threatening to kill each other online over a latex mask.
We couldn't have summed that up any better. But like you said, you started your own Facebook group, much like I did mine, to escape the BS of, again, the other groups that shall not be named, because everyone thinks that their opinion is the only one that matters. I know people that have a Rehaul Tots Elrod mask, and they love it to death. And then I know some people who have a high-end NAG converted by JC, and they're not happy with it. So, you know, it's not – the money you spend doesn't guarantee the happiness that you're that you'll have.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Speaking of which, what is the name of your group so that people can find it?
Funny enough, it's called Mask Hub.
Mask Hub.
Mask Hub, 50 members. Again, I really don't care about the number of the members. I could care less about having a group with the amount of people that are in other groups such as MM.net, because most of them are assholes anyway, and I really wouldn't want them in my group. I invited, you know, people that I know are good people, you know, collectors that I know I can trust. I don't want any scam shit going on, any bullshit. If there's any slight problem, most likely someone's going to get removed. I don't want any problems whatsoever in a group. I don't care if that means I have to have 10 members in it. If that's what it takes, that's what it takes. I don't want any drama. Again, this is a hobby of collecting latex masks. At the end of the day, it sounds, you know, it is what it is, though. I mean, I don't think really people stop and realize what they're actually getting into and what they're actually arguing over, how stupid it is. I just find it stupid when I see, you know, like grown 40, 50-year-old men arguing on Facebook saying they're going to, like, fly to whatever state it is or country and kill them or beat them up or steal whatever they have over a disagreement of what they think is a better mask or just something stupid in general. And it's all about latex masks. It blows my mind that people will go to the extent of a murder charge over a latex mask.
If it makes you feel any better, it's not just that. If you, any part of life that people disagree with you, they'll threaten to kill you.
Yeah, it's just, I find it stupid. Like you're really gonna, you know, spend the rest of your life in prison over a few $100 mask? Is it really that serious?
Like, it's like, you like hockey, right?
Yeah, play.
What's your favorite NHL team?
That's tough. I know what you're gonna, but I guess I'd say the Devils for the.
See, I like the Blackhawks, so now I have to kill you because you don't like the Blackhawks.
You know, it's unfortunate, but there's people that say things like that, and I just sit back and shake my head. It's kind of like,
it's good entertainment.
It is an entertainment, you know, and this, you know, I get a lot of entertainment, such as, you know, categories and topics like that from AJ Good. I get a lot of entertainment from him ripping on people, which is, I mean, I think, you know, I should shut my mouth about that one. Never mind. I'm not getting into that stuff.
Oh, man. But your collection, you know, it's a lot of quality. I'm glad to see that as young as you are, you've got the wisdom to be more concerned with that than the number of masks that you have. And not to say that you can't have a lot and like them. I know people with dozens and they love them for different reasons. But you're more concerned with getting to that end goal as opposed to just gobbling up everything that you see, which financially is great. And, you know, as a 16-year-old, you know, you're not too much younger than me, but needless to say, most 16-year-olds don't have the wherewithal enough to do that.
Right. And usually when I tell people, they're kind of shocked. And mostly it comes from cosplaying at conventions because I have a mask on. And, you know, the stuff I have, other collectors notice and they come up and talk to me. And then I take it off. It's like, wait, how old are you? I'm like, you know, 16, or at the time of these stores, like 15. And like, surprised because of not only the stuff I have, but they thought I originally was older, I guess, because of my size. Like, I'm about 6'3 and like about 220. Like, I don't really look like the average 16-year-old, but now almost 17, but it's still fairly young regarding, you know, people that, you know, are collecting these types of, you know, pieces. I mean, most of the people I talk to on a daily basis are like decades older than me, literally.
I feel you on that one. And wow, you are a big son of a bitch.
Yeah.
I thought I mean, I'm 6'1" and about 145.
No, yeah, I'm fairly big.
But, you know, play a lot of ice hockey, so you got to stay in shape for beating people to death.
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, I'm a goalie, but it does happen sometimes. You know, sometimes people get annoying and they get in your face, but not to the extent as, I guess, you know, some of my teammates that are defensemen and forwards, but it happens sometimes.
Speaking of goalies, you're wearing a Friday shirt. Where are them hockey masks at, brother?
Don't have any more. I had two full Jason setups. I had my part 3 and my part 8, which I sold to get money to buy Myers masks. Because I got heavily into Myers, you know. The addiction was strong for the masks. And I sold my costume. Dude, I had two crash masks, man, too. It was good. They were good.
We gotta costumes. Fix that, man. We gotta fix that. We gotta get you some hockey masks.
I want to get some stuff from you, man. I definitely want to get back into Jason. If I do another Jason, it's most likely gonna be a part 6.
Man, I just finished one. I'll shoot you a picture, man. That's becoming my specialty. Not trying to put myself over, but you know, I've had some great teachers. Or if nothing, I can at least point you to who make the top of the top line. If you don't want to, you know, some people, because you know, Crashton. Guys like him and Oz have tremendous wait times, as you would expect when you're as high up the food chain as they have been for such a long time. But I can definitely hook you up, man.
Yeah, dude, I would love that, because definitely want to get back into Jason eventually. I can't really say when, because right now I'm still in that Myers frenzy, and I don't see it stopping for at least a while.
In the midst of a 6 right now. It's just been raining here in Georgia for like a fucking week, so I haven't been able to paint anything, so I'm getting behind.
It's only been raining for me for about 2 days.
And you got that Jersey weather, so it's probably cold as fuck up there, too.
Dude, I couldn't tell you. I don't get cold, man. I really don't.
See, you're like my brother. You're one of those people. It could be outside snowing. You'll be out there in a tank top and shorts and be like, absolutely. It's lovely.
Yeah, I don't get cold, man.
If it gets below 70, I'm shivering. And if it gets below 80, above 80, I'm dying.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, for me, like, I can get hot pretty quick, but cold, I really don't get cold. Like, a lot of times in hockey, like, we'll have team workouts and shit, we'll be, like, running around the rink in, like, short sleeves for, like, two hours sometimes working out just in the ice rink itself, and it's like, you know, whatever the temperature it is in there, you know, pretty cold for most people, but I'm just used to it. Years and years of just every day being in an ice rink, just, yeah, used to it.
That's inhuman. I would love to see you in a Jason cosplay, because you'd probably just be so maniacal and
I got pictures, man. And as big as I am, I still wear shoulder padding and muscle suits and height installments. Dude, I was about like 6'6", and I looked fucking jacked in my part 8 and my part 3 because I was wearing all that shit on top of it. Like, I think a Jason, like, I don't just want to be big. I want to be fucking humongous. Like, Jason, to me, like, mentally, is a huge fucking character. And I am big just to start with, but why not go fucking bigger if you can? But, dude, those height installments of my boots fucking killed my feet so bad. The hugest blizzard. I couldn't walk. I would wear it sometimes for 12 hours at cons. Couldn't even walk afterward.
But it was worth it.
I would take them, and they were hard plastic shits, and I would take them and modify them to about, like, 3-4 inches. So I was looking pretty big, man, and that shit too.
I thought, you know, that's why when I cosplayed this past Halloween as part 6, I picked part 6. CJ's not that tall, but, like, you know, you did part 3. Richard Broker was probably about 6'6" without any, you know, help. Or you guys like Derek Mears who are 6'6", you know. I tend to go for the smaller, skinnier Roy Byrne-esque Jasons to cosplay as. So I don't have to wear so much
shoulder padding. The way I look at things like cosplay, if there's an image, I'm going to try as close as I can to replicate it. I mean, as soon as I, like even for Myers stuff, like, if my head shape's off in a mask, like, I'll try putting stuffing in to make it look like either a warlock stretch on previous masks or more of a castle stretch. I would put shit underneath my chin and on the sides. Like, I just want to replicate things to, I don't care how many little details it takes. I just want to try to get myself personally to look as close as I can. to whatever it was in the movie. Like the Jason stuff, I spent hours just weathering shit on my part three, like just small shit that no one's even ever going to see. I'm just doing it because I think that, you know, if this was a real life thing, like, oh, there'd be things here and there and looking at pictures and this and that shit. I made my full part three costume. The only thing I didn't make was the hood and hawk. That's it. Everything else I made.
That's amazing, man. The passion really shows through it. I appreciate you coming on and sharing it with me because, you know, I think it's lost on a lot of people. And like you said, some of these older, more bitter people.
Yeah, for sure.
It's great to see you carrying on the hobby with, you know, your passion.
Thanks, man. Yeah, I really love this stuff, truly. Like, I know a lot of people say, you know, they like this, but I truly love it. Like, I live and breathe this stuff. Like, every day I'm constantly on my phone, like, you know, socializing with, you know, either the Myers shit or other people, even in school. Like I'll be in class just on my phone constantly, just being, like, just talking to people, checking shit out, because this is, like, besides hockey, this is, like, my second lifestyle, man. Like, it brings me true happiness, you know, collecting this shit. And it's not shit, but, you know what I'm trying to say. But, yeah, I just love it. And I'm not only just a horror collector. I collect music memorabilia, sports memorabilia. There's so much stuff I collect. Like, pop figures, autographs. I don't know what type of music you're into, but, my personal favorite genre is rock. Okay, yeah. I mean,
there you go. I don't know if you can see it.
Yeah, I see it. Yeah, so, I mean, I collect, you know, tons of, you know, rock, music autographs, sports, horror, all that stuff. I got so much stuff I got to put up, but I don't have enough space to put up in my room, so I just got to figure out some other places. But, like, I'm just looking at my wall now. Like, my personal favorite, you know, may come as a surprise, but my personal favorite artist is Queen. The band, and I've been a fan way longer the movie came out, so I could tell you any fact about Queen ever, but I've got on my wall, I'm looking at right now, I have every single studio album I have that they released, first press, some are UK, most of them are UK, but some are US, on my wall framed right there. Over there I've got a canvas painting of Freddie Mercury. There I got Freddie Mercury's autograph, the guitar players and the drummers. That Freddie autograph was not cheap. Those things don't come up that often, and real ones are expensive. That was not.
Oh, well, you know, there's not any more of them coming out these days.
Yeah, no.
You have to settle for Adam Lambert.
I guess so. Dude, I got a weird story about him, too, man. It was kind of weird. I was sitting front row at a show, and he just kept hitting on me the whole entire show. It was really awkward and weird.
I mean, you get those unlimited backstage passes, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I just kept trying to look away. Like, it was getting to a point where it was, like, really uncomfortable. Like, he would come up every, like, 3 seconds and, like, lick his lips and, like, wink at me. It was really weird. Very, very
uncomfortable. Well, I think getting sexually harassed by Adam Lambert's a good place to end the show.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
So let the people know your Instagram so they can come check out your collection as it grows.
So my Instagram is TheShapeNJ, all one word. My Facebook is my name, Marino Lupo, MarinoLupo. You'd be surprised of how many people have, you know, thought my name was something else, like Marinara, Marno, Mario. I get it all the time. But, yeah, Marino
Lupo. Must be Lupo. Italian.
I am, yeah. I am, plus some other stuff, but mostly that, yeah. But, yeah, my Instagram is TheShapeNJ. Check out my stuff there. I post there pretty frequently. I post everywhere pretty frequently. But I have some new stuff coming in early next week. Like I was telling you earlier privately, I have a Cinema Secrets deluxe mask coming in, like, mint condition. Literally no flaws, no problems with the hair. Looks awesome. And I sourced the same exact pair of coveralls using Resurrection and boots. So I'm going to be getting all those in. I'm going to have a full Resurrection outfit fairly soon. Probably gonna wear that to a convention with some other stuff I've got going on.
Awesome, man. Well, thanks for coming on the show. Everyone
anytime,
knows man. all my information.
And anytime,
for Marino Lupo, I'm Dylan Cloud, and until next time, we're gonna leave it here on the cutting room floor.